Good morning, Guam. What's up? It's Friday. It's time for another edition of Fit AF this morning. I'm working with a longtime friend of mine, a legend in the water, and of course, the man now of paradise. I'm not saying he's the madman because I don't want to put him in on the spot like that. But I mean, you know, he's a gentleman. He's here. He's working out, taking care of his health, among other things he's doing in his life. One of the things that you're very ambitious about, something that you've grown internationally that started here in Guam, the heart of the Marianas. We got the Marianas Open going, and I know you've got the Marianas Pro that travels around the world. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that before we begin this morning?
Okay. Hafide, hi, everybody.
Steve Shimizu, ladies and gentlemen.
Trying to catch my breath. Anyway, so Marianas Open started 2007. Doing jiu-jitsu, what I love. Met this guy, too. He's in the game as well. We took it to a different level as far as tournaments. We decided, you know, a lot of our Guam people go off island to compete, but they don't have the funds to do it. So instead of going to a prestigious tournament, why not make our own? So we formed the Marianas Open. And from there on, it just started with 30 people, increased to 50. Then all of a sudden, it's 200 competitors. Now we're at 3. We went even further and started the Marianas Pro, which is a qualifier around the world. So we started off in Japan, headed to El Paso, Vegas, San Diego, Korea. And that qualifier brings the best of each country to Guam. So now, in August, all of those 5 countries that competed in the Marianas Pro now are coming to compete in this year's Marianas Open in August. So it gives our athletes a chance to go up against the world's best. And the world's best will be coming here. I don't want to say just who, but it will be a surprise because it's going to make headlines. So I would say local competitors, enter now because this is your chance to go up against the best in the world.
And that's something that's really, I mean, like you said, it started out with that vision. You're absolutely right. The really living in such an isolated place, it doesn't matter what year it is, right? 2019, we still have to spend a lot of money to get out there, to be exposed to some of the top talents globally. And so, you know, I appreciate it, even though I'm not competing in jiu-jitsu, but I appreciate the fact that you're bringing that talent back to Guam, so that way the guys here in Guam, the best, you know, as good as they are here in Guam, they get to test themselves against the world's best.
Yes, for sure. You know, it's like any other sport. Everybody wants to see where they stand. Everybody wants to say, you know, it's fine. We're challenging each other, but really, jiu-jitsu is a individual sport where you're not up against your opponent. You're up against yourself, and the number one athlete is really yourself. You're not going to compete against the guy that's to your right, to the guys to your left. It's the guy inside of you, the person inside of you. So, you know, you compete against our best here, but now it gives you this chance to compete against the world's best, from Asia to the U.S. to from Brazil. And you know, this is one of the only opportunities for athletes that cannot afford to go abroad, that do fundraisers, all of this stuff to try and get there. Well, you know what? You wake up in the morning, go down from your house in Malolo and go straight to the Mililao Phoenix Center and compete against the world's best. So it's right in our backyard, guys. And you know, I can't say thank everybody for, you know, the opportunity of allowing us to do this and watching Guam's best compete. I mean, it's an honor to watch these young kids grow into such, man, awesome athletes. So today's kids will probably be world champions tomorrow. So, you know, that's where we're at now.
All right, so he's been doing that, and that in itself is a monumentous endeavor. I mean, to take something and grow it, bring it into something international. And so part of the way that he maintains and sustains that energy and, of course, the mental capacity to be able to do that is by working it out in here. And so he's going to run me through a little bit of a little circuit. We're going to go through that. We're going to do some tire flipping, box jump onto a tire flip. We're going to do some sled pushing. What else?
Well, we don't have mats, so we can't do that. So we're just going to do everything we would do to add into your jiu-jitsu game. This was taught to me by a lot of different guys that are in the sport today that If you're doing jiu-jitsu, you want to add in a little bit extra, and there's nothing wrong with doing something outside of the norm. Train every day, do your thing on the mat, but if you can add in a little bit more, it gives you that little punch. And I guess for me, during the times I would compete, Steve Oshiro had showed me these workouts that really helped me improve my game. And I think that everybody could use a little spunk there.
Okay. All right, so we'll let you go ahead and continue on the tire flip, or what?
You first.
Okay, you got me. Let me get my glasses down. Can't bring my nerd glasses into the gym when I'm going to do my thing.
You're on first, dude. Here, let's bring this all the way to the beginning.
Oh, okay, shucks.
No fair. All right.
I'm going to need somebody to hold the mic. I'll have him show me, and then I'll have him hold the mic. Sprawl, box jump, and then I'm going all the way down to the rig, that rig. Okay. All right.
You just get it out of the way here. Oh.
Julius the man.
This is not an inner tube. This is like an actual off-roading tire.
Look at those guns, dude. Come on, man. Boom. Okay, back.
Oh, back?
You can go all the way. It's up to you.
No, I'll go back now. If I'm gonna have to go back anyway.
Because you gotta push that, dude.
Okay.
That's my mom. You ever meet my mom?
Yeah.
That's why he's so in shape, right? Yeah. No. twice a week. Can't do that every day.
Oh. Yeah. It's getting harder to jump up.
Yep.
How's he doing?
Better than me. One more, dude.
That's really cool. Like, that thing, my legs.
All right.
Hard.
Push forward. Here. Go up high and go down low. All the way to the end. Run it, Jules. There you go. Okay, stop. Go the other way, but go down low. Like mountain climbers from below. And push hard, fast. Ready? Go. Come on. Sprint. Come on, all the way. Nice. Last one before our minute work, before our minute break. Box jumps. Folks, can I borrow the man? The man, the myth.
So what is he going to be doing?
You're just going to do box jumps, 15. Get 15 in. Rep. Yep. He said he wanted to do it. I don't do it as fast. Do it on the blue. Do it on the blue. Get it on the blue.
I want to
do 10. Do 10.
They won't.
Boom! That's one.
Brain till legs, too bad.
Two, rest up there. Three. Four. Twice a week, I at least do this. Four more. Three more.
I know.
Two more. One last one, Jules. Last one, make it count. Boom. Okay, 2 minute rest.
The cold air is killing me. The cold air is killing me. My throat is dry. And it's amazing when your brain is telling your legs to do something and your legs are acting like a stubborn child. They just don't want to work. Oh, 1 second. The AC is like a shock to my system. So that's going to wrap it up for Fit AF this morning. That's both the punchline and the finish line. Thank you, Steve. No appreciate problem, your man. Time.
Yes.
Appreciate you.
Man.
Yeah, yeah. Appreciate you guys joining us. And we'll see you next week. It's another installment of Fit AF.